music America loves best. Presenting the brilliant baritone voice of Robert Merrill, star of the Metropolitan Opera, in a program of music secure in American hearts. Songs and melodies known and loved all across the land. Here is Music America Loves Best.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Kenneth Banghart. Something about this first song, maybe its swashbuckling sentiment, maybe its rollicking vigor. Anyhow, it has stirred American hearts from the very beginning. Here's Robert Merrill to sing it for us, The Song of the Open Road. Bob?
What in the world could be so sweet as the thunder and clatter of horses' feet and a song of the open road? Tomorrow's another day. Let me love and then ride away. Life is short, they say, and maybe for me, so let me be free. I'm on the road to anywhere. Let me travel on with no more load and no more care, just like a cover my head. Why should I want a feather bed? So let me travel and sing my song of the road, the long, long road, the song of the open road.
Today's morning and last week's vigil will soon recede in favor of the bright recollections of him that belong to us. That was what Oscar Hammerstein said about his late collaborator. It was the way all America felt about the passing of Jerome Kern, because his music belongs to us now and for all time. All the things you are. Thank you. Music America Loves Best is a reflection of the land itself, a great and colorful patchwork quilt of the world. From 100 different nations, the music we know and love comes to mingle with our native songs. Robert Merrill offers a fine example of this partnership as he sings a modern dress version of a melody by Edvard Grieg, Strange Music. One way to discover the music America loves best is to ask its people, and that's exactly what we've done. The James Pollocks live in Rochester, New York. Of three sons, two were in the service. Jim is back now, but Eddie's resting in the loamy earth of North Africa. When it came to talking about the music they loved best, everyone agreed that Mom should make the selection. Mom said, "I suppose you'll think this song is kind of old-fashioned, but I think it means something to lots of folks. I know I'll never get tired of it." Well, no one was more pleased with Mrs. Pollock's selection than our own Robert Merrill. Isn't that so, Bob?
That's right, Ken. Because it's one of my favorites, too. Adam Geibel wrote his beloved lullaby 50 years ago. So here it is for Mrs. Pollock. Sleep, Kentucky Babe.
Humming under honeysuckle vine, sleep Kentucky babe. Sandman am a coming to this little man of mine, sleep Kentucky babe. Silvery moon am pining in the heavens up above, trouble, ink and pine and foe, his little lady love. You is mighty lucky, babe of old Kentucky. Close your eyes in sleep. Fly away. Fly away, Kentucky babe. Fly away to rest. Fly away. Lay your kinky woolly head on your mammy's breast. With his little dog and gun. Sleep, Kentucky babe. Possum for your breakfast when your sleeping time is done. Sleep, Kentucky babe. Boogeyman will catch you sure unless you close your eyes. Waiting just outside the door to take you by surprise. Best be keeping shady, little colored lady. Close your eyes in sleep. Fly away. Fly away, Kentucky babe. Fly away to rest. Fly away. Lay your kinky woolly head on your mammy's breast.
Over the years since America began, more and more of our music makers have wakened to the wealth of inspiration that's in our native ground. Music in our many tongues, in the names we call things, in the songs our people sing. One song folks in America have been singing for something like half a century is a rousing tune called When Johnny Comes Marching Home. We're going to hear a delightful adaptation of it now, written by Morton Gould. Here is American Salute. Immigrant and native born, young and old, the anonymous ones and the great names, this is our music, the music America loves best. When we asked Olivia de Havilland to name her favorite music, she pursed her lips and knitted her brows in a way that's familiar to 90 million moviegoers. I don't know where to begin, she said. I could give you a list of favorites, but it would take from June to January to play them all. And then after a moment's thought, she said, I know. They played this song at my school dance in Los Gatos, California. It's such a beautiful, haunting tune. I've loved it ever since. Well, Bob, how does Olivia de Havilland's choice strike you?
Just fine, Ken. It's a song that has pleasant associations for many of us, and it's one of really greater melodies of the American popular music. Cole Porter's Night and Day.
Night and day, you are the one. Under the star, whether near to me or far, it's no matter, darling, where you are, I think of you. Night and day, day and night, why is it so that this longing for you follows wherever I go? In the roaring traffic's boom, in the silence of my lonely room, I think of you. Night and day, night and day, under the hide of me, there's ain't oh such a hungry yearning burning inside of me. And it's torment won't be through till you let me spend my life making love to you. Day and night, night and day. Like the beat, beat, beat of the tom-tom when the jungle shadows fall, like the tick, tick, tock of the stately clock as it stands against the wall, like the drip, drip, drip of the raindrops when the summer showers through, so a voice within me keeps repeating you, you.
Music America Loves Best is written by Ed Jurist and produced by George Woutsas. And this is Kenneth Banghart wishing you a very pleasant good afternoon.
This is the Armed Forces Radio Service.